Thank you. There are so many great things you could do with a Friday evening in Naples, Florida. We're humbled and honored that you're here sharing this music with us. We really appreciate you being here this evening to hear this wonderful cantata and the other works that we have. I'm going to talk a little bit here just for a moment. It's the only time I'll talk tonight, I promise. While I'm doing it, our host, Dr. Becky Weiss, who's such a gracious and wonderful host here at the church, has agreed to do a free will offering if you are so inclined. So she's coming around with that. Oh, and she said checks be made out to Florida Gulf Coast University. But we're very gracious for you to be here. I will tell you that before she does that, that in the 12 years that I've been here at Florida Gulf Coast University, all of these proceeds always go directly to the students, chiefly especially to international experiences that they do. Next year we're looking at being the rotation year for the chamber choir and their next tour. 2020 was the last time this group toured. We made it just in time before COVID shut everything down. Maybe not just in time. We were kind of in the midst of it in Italy, of all places. So since I like to go to hot places, I thought maybe I was looking at Ukraine and some places like that for our next... No, I'm just kidding. I'm not. That's a joke. Moms and dads, relax. That was a joke. It was a bad joke, but it was a joke. But we're very gracious. If you are thinking about something else through another span of the evening or at another way to support the students at another time, please be sure to reach out to me if there's a student that you'd be particularly interested in helping to support to make an international tour possible. These are great things, something that I've done now several times here at FGCU. I know that for me as a student in 1900 at the University of Wisconsin-Eau Claire, this was one of the most profound, life-changing experiences of my life, was going on choir tour with the singing statesmen of the University of Wisconsin-Eau Claire. Being a boy from a small town in east central Wisconsin, Plymouth, Wisconsin, population us and all the cows, 6,000, having been once to Florida in sixth grade on a trip with my family, and then many times once a year to Milwaukee to see the Milwaukee Symphony Orchestra, going overseas was a big life changer. And I know it is for a lot of these students also. The work you heard was Bach's epic cantata, Christlag in Todesbanden. It's an Easter cantata. It's interesting because of all of the Easter cantatas that Bach wrote, it's the only one that doesn't have a wind complement. It's only strings. There's no winds. And it's the one that's predominantly in a minor key throughout it. So it's not unheard of for it to be a chorale cantata. You heard the chorale come back many times, but the fact that it is that it's only strings and it's this E minor that wrestles within itself all the time in the melody and tends to, at the end of each movement, end in E major. It is the maybe the most beautiful musical struggle of eternal life's victory over death. And I'm just so glad. Originally, I had planned to perform a different cantata that was actually the cantata for this Sunday, which is, I think, the sixth Sunday after Pentecost, Zegzema Sunday. If you Google that, spell it very carefully. There are some searches, things that you don't want to come back. But inevitably, I thought that Christlag in Todesbanden was a better choice. This next ensemble that you'll hear is our newly formed first performance, world premiere of our men's choir at Florida Gulf Coast University. Yes. That's very generous of you. Very generous of you. You haven't even heard them yet. So I hope that we live up to your thunderous applause. But we're very excited to have this ensemble perform. We'll do a few selections for you. We'll come back with the chamber choir then to close things off. So we'll begin with maybe one of the most quintessential bass tenor songs for any ensemble that has to know, their first piece. I think it's the first piece we looked at when we started singing together in January, Viva l'Amour.
Viva la compagnie!
Success to each other and pass it along.
Viva la compagnie!
Viva la, viva la, viva l'amour! Viva la, viva la, viva l'amour! Viva l'amour, viva l'amour! Viva la compagnie!
Come all you good fellows and join in with me. Viva la compagnie! And raise up your voices in close harmony.
Viva la compagnie! Viva la, viva la, viva l'amour! Viva la, viva la, viva
time or occasion compel us to part.
Viva la company.
This day shall forever enlighten the heart.
Viva la, viva la, viva la.
Let every old bachelor fill up his glass.
Viva la, viva la company.
And drink to the health of his favorite lass.
Viva.
The silence, I'll talk just really quickly now about this next piece. Set Me as a Seal is from a larger work called A New Creation by Rene Clausen. Rene Clausen was a choral director and composer who taught at Concordia College in Moorhead, Minnesota for a very, very long time. This particular piece, Set Me as a Seal, was composed in the span of about 20 minutes. Rene's wife was, Rene and his wife Frankie had difficulty conceiving and had several miscarriages. And they were close to, I think it was 6 months into this pregnancy. And the doctor was concerned and had decided to do an amnio. And in the procedure, had killed the baby in the process. And so they came home, of course, heartbroken, and he went to his studio and put this piece together. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal upon your arm, for love is strong as death.
Oh.
Once again, I would like to thank Naples United Church of Christ, our host, Dr. Becky Weiss, for having us here. We do several concerts here during the year, and it's always a great experience. We'll be back in just a couple months, so please keep your eye on that next date when we will have the Women's Choir and the University Choir here near the end of the year also, and hope to see you there, and at the Chamber Choir's next performance, which is near the end of April also at Bower Chapel. I'm hoping that's in the program. If not, it's probably on the internet somewhere, but please find us out there on the webs and in the metaverse. Find us. We're not there yet. We're working on it, though. Right, Pepe? Okay, one more piece.